save and game. Bam! Awesome. We are into game number one between these two. Ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce you into the round of 16. My sounds here are a little bit too low, so let me just adjust that. But let's get into it. Spawning up here in the top right-hand corner from Team SCC, it is our Yellow Zerg. It's none other than Tai 2. Sorry, bottom right-hand corner.
That confused me for a second. And spawning in the top right 2 o'clock position, we do have the Orange Terran. It is... I knew this is the wrong clan name. It is Terra. That's the easiest way of doing it.
It's just Terra you. Or you.
Or you.
Is
yeah,
or you the counter to know you?
That would be really weird. I noticed the turn rate's going down, so I'm going to make sure I've got nothing else running. Just in case, because I don't want to cause any lag.
No, I think it was 12 last game we were in, too. I think we should be fine, yeah. 12 is the minimum that I put for everything. Alright, so I just went down to 10. If it goes really, really low, then we could just do the screen sharing bit that we were thinking about before.
Yeah, it seems weird that it would drop so much, because I've done a turn rate 16 game before they end, blink turn rate 20 with Terra before, and I play with Tai 2 a bit, so...
Yeah, it's just when you have, like, I mean, we have you, who's all the way in Europe, I'm in California, Terra's all the way in South America, and Tai 2 is somewhere in North America? Question mark?
I can't remember where he's from. I think he might be East Coast, maybe?
I think Canadian. Down to TR8. Alright, so if they complain, we can move out. If not, we're fine. I mean, it's still, like, L1 lag. I mean, if you remember, this is actually just pretty much what all of Ladder was when... SCR launched anyway, so...
Yeah, I think the counter's a bit bugged as well. It seems to be since the last patch, like, dynamic seems a wee bit bugged. I'm not sure why, and I'm sure they're fixing it, but it seems to go down and then it doesn't actually affect anything, so I don't know. Maybe it's just being weird, but it doesn't look like there's too much lag, which is good.
So, let's talk about things that are going on right now, because this is not a standard TVZ in any way, shape, or form. We've got Tai 2 down here, who's already got the spawning pool at 9. We've got the extractor that I went down, I believe, at 8. And now the next hatchery has gone down at 12. Meanwhile, what's going on in Terra's base?
Terra is going for a fairly standard... Well, it looks like he's going for 1-1-1, so... I mean, I'd like to say that's not standard, because it never used to be, but it certainly is now. It's probably the secondary standard build. Whether or not he goes into mech from here, or if he's just going to go for wraiths, I'm not too sure. But he did pull guys off gas for a little bit to get a little bit of extra minerals, so...
Oops. Forgot to turn D&D back on. Yeah, so it looks like he's going to be... Oh, no! Not 1-1-1. 1-2. we got a double factory coming out here from Terror, which is very interesting. I've actually never really seen dual fact at the beginning, except for Goliath rushes.
Yeah, it could be one of the really weird, interesting builds you can do in TBC. It's not that common. It's actually two factory vulture, just really early. It's not as common as, say, sort of in TBP, and even then it's not the most common build, but it's a really good... sort of early aggressive opening. You get speed first usually, and then go into mines, but it depends on if he's going to go for two machine chops or just one.
Well, this is very cute here from Tai 2, going to be moving the Zergling over here to the corner, and then up into the middle of the map so that the scouting SCV doesn't actually see this many Zergling. Zergling do have speed now, that was picked up from the extractor. And that is going to be really... Oh, wait, no, hold on. Tai 2 just doesn't know where the other base is.
Yeah, Tai 2 has checked with his overlord, not seen an expansion, and just assumed that means that Terra must be in a different position. He didn't actually drone scout here, so sending his links in the wrong direction. And that's going to give Terra enough time to get his vulture at this off his ramp. And if you'll notice, he's actually hiding his extra ones, so he doesn't want it obvious to Tai 2 to see what he's doing, so this could be quite dangerous.
Oh, but the SCV's pulled away at the last second! Oh, that's a little scary. Speed has not finished up yet, but it should be finishing up very soon. Speed's a very quick upgrade. And that's a lot of Ultra starting to build up, and Tai-2 doesn't have any sunken colonies set up for this either, so he's gonna have to hold the ramp at, or catch these vultures completely out of position.
Okay, the first upgrade's now finished. It was, in fact, speed. He's gonna go straight in here, and this could be a very, very quick victory for Terra, as long as he micros this correctly. But that's a really nice drone drill.
Yeah, a really awesome drone drill is gonna keep Tai-2 alive for a little bit longer, and Tai-2 is just barely trying to get the Mutalisk out. Now, the engineering bay has finished, is just about to finish up here, and the missile turrets are going to be key, but there's just nothing left to defend. The Mutalisks are just about to pop here. They will be able to clean up the rest of these vultures, but these vultures are taking out so many drones.
I don't like to call games early, but I think as long as Terra micros properly, he can actually just close out the game here and now. Looks like he's got his armory alive back at home. He's probably going into Goliath range. He's got his engineering bay getting a few missile turrets as well. And Tai-2 is really far behind at this point compared to where he wants to be.
Yeah, I mean, there's not that many drones. I mean, look at how incredibly lackluster the saturation is at the natural. There's only 3 drones over there. There's, what, 8 drones down here in the bottom right-hand corner? Okay, it looks like maybe more like 10, but still, not that many drones around the map out here for Tai-2 right now. You don't really want to saturate the natural anyway, just because of the fear of those vultures. But at this point, Terra's already spun off of building more vultures and is going straight on into Goliath production to deal with those Mutalisks.
Yeah, the other thing is you can see that Tai-2 is a little bit too worried to actually move out on the map with his Mutalisks, so he's not even getting any damage done. I mean, it would have been quite difficult to damage him anyway due to the fact Terra is just holed up on one base, and his turret positioning is actually really nice in this game, so that's something going for him. And Terra, being quite clever, actually leaving the last 2 vultures that he has just out on the middle of the map, just waiting to go for that backstab. There is 2 Lings on the ramp, but they're not going to be able to hold the vultures for long.
Yeah, I don't think these vultures will find that much luck just because the Mutalisks are here, but they do come in. Oh my god, I forgot how fast vultures are. Come in, take out a drone, and then just immediately evacuate. Very beautiful micro there from Terra.
Yeah, the Sunken Colony is going to finish soon, which means it's going to be a little bit harder to do. He's going to have to repair his vultures if he wants to go back in, and he's likely going to lose one on the way. Oh, never mind, he's going to lose them to the Mutalisks. It's all good though, he is adding up to his, well, he's got his third factory going and he's adding on his command center. But when these Mutalisk numbers start going up, it's going to be quite difficult for him to expand.
Yeah, I mean, Goliaths are really good in anti-air. We saw, you know, an amazing TVT just before where Goliaths were able to shred apart things like battlecruisers and wraiths. But Mutalisks actually have quite a good amount of health, and not only that, are considered as small. And so, medium. So, Goliaths do very little damage to them. They still are able to fend off Mutalisks generally in large numbers. Once they get Charon boosters, they are able to do so easier. I believe that's probably what the machine shop is now finally spinning on. I bet those vultures were getting mines first? No mines. So, just like Charon boosters, just taking a long time to upgrade.
I think Charon boosters are probably finished. This is probably going to be mines. Okay. He's going to want to get it sometime. Looks like he may be able to get this drone if he micros this correctly. Can he do it?
Ooh! Wow, extractor at the last second.
Oh, he's got a bind there. He can't expand there now until the Overlord gets there.
It's right there. Meanwhile, looks like Tai-2 is going to be able to stop this expansion from going down for just a little bit longer. There are a good number of Goliaths over here, but Tai-2 has been pumping out a lot of Mutalisks. Like, a lot. And I think that number of Mutalisks is just a little bit too scary for those Goliaths.
Yeah, it's kind of strange. He went for a 2 hatchery play anyway, and then because he took so much drone damage early on, it's meant he's had to rebuild his drones, but now he's finally well saturated in his main. His saturation for at least 2 hatch Mutalisks isn't too bad on his natural either. He's at least got his gas fully mining, so these Mutalisk numbers are going to keep rising, I could imagine.
Exactly, and I mean, there's already more than 12 out on the map. There's going to be 2 control groups soon enough. Mutalisk poking in on the main base, going to do a little bit of damage, going to stop that science facility from going down immediately. And this science facility is kind of vulnerable to just constantly being stopped here. These Mutas are doing a good amount of work in order to stop this from happening. One Mutalisk finally going down here. But that was a lot of damage before one Mutalisk even fell.
Yeah, and the thing is, it's going to be very similar to a few games we've seen over the past couple of days where Now Terra is going to have to defend across two locations, and due to the mutilus numbers, turrets aren't really going to be able to cut it. There's nearly two full control groups of mutilus, and they absolutely shred turrets.
Mm-hmm.
So either Terra is going to need to go into Valkyries or vessels very quickly. It looks like we do have Radiate finally researching with the vessels, and he is adding more turrets as well.
But even then, with a little bit of nice micro, you're going to be able to out maneuver that Irradiate. But right now, it looks like just the Mutilus guy is going to try and bust through the Goliath. Oh my god! Tai 2 taking a huge disadvantage in the early game is going to just be able to bully the way through game number one here. Oh my god, the complete utter destruction of the natural. This is amazing.
This is why Goliaths are so awkward, because you can feel like you have enough and then this will happen. And it feels so bad when it happens, but with proper micro, you could still kill all these Mutilus. It's going to be very difficult, especially with the Mutilus on top of everything, but they're so badly bruised that these turrets are finally being able to do the damage they need to do.
But still, even with as many units as you can possibly pump out, there's only one Goliath and one Science Missile. Science Missile definitely needs 75 energy, so this is why Science Missiles are generally okay against Mutilus later on in the game, but as soon as it pops out, incredibly ineffective here.
Yeah, this is why we started to see in about 2009, players like Fantasy and Ooh starting to incorporate Valkyries into their play when they were going mech, purely because Goliaths on their own, they have their weaknesses, and this is certainly one of them, but that's a really nice Irradiate.
It will be able to split up and just immediately throw it into the mineral line.
Yeah, using the Eraser trick against the Terra, not the best, but here we go, there's some more turrets up finally. There is no more Irradiates, but they should, with a good repair, he should be able to hold on here just about. And Tai 2's drone count is still quite low, he's only really saturated in his main base.
Oh my god, if Terra is able to hold on here, it's going to be absolutely one of the best holds ever.
It's going to be very difficult. More Mutilus coming in from the other side, and he's actually got no way of keeping his units alive when they spawn. That's the big problem. He's going to be able to hold on to his natural at least for now, but the Goliaths are going straight down as they spawn.
I mean, I think at this point, all Tai 2 needs to do is just build a bunch of Zergling and be able to just bust through the natural. There's not really any ground protection here. And with the production line getting completely destroyed, I don't know what Terra is going to be able to do.
There was a really nice move at 6 o'clock. Terra actually bought that one vulture back in, killed 5 drones, and then disappeared again. It looks like another bunch of drones are being transferred over, but that was at least a little bit of damage. I don't think it's going to be enough, but it's better than nothing. All the factories are going down. One does die. The second one about to burn down as well. And I think Terra is just trying to, fire out Tai 2 here.
Yeah, it's a dangerous situation, and the Science Vessel is about to have another Radiate available, but that's really banking on a lot, especially with how the Mutilus are already spread up. They don't really need to be clumped together like they normally do in the mid-game for Terran vs. Zerg. So there's a really nice Radiate, actually, but, again, split out very quickly.
Yeah, split up very quickly. There's so many Mutilus still as well. He's trying to build turrets by his factory to keep it alive. But he's lost his main command center. He's going to lose his second factory. And with just one factory producing Goliaths, he may even lose the armory if Tai 2 finds it. And then there's going to be nothing he can do.
Yeah, I think at this point, probably taking out the armory and the science facility are going to be the top two targets here for Tai 2.
Well, the vulture's going back into the bottom, but there's Mutilus there to defend against this.
It does have 6 kills, though. Will finally fall. Starting to build more missile turrets down here at the factory. The lone factory that's left, by the way.
Yeah, and we're 14 minutes into the game, and Terra's only on 28 supply. This is kind of crazy.
Yeah, it's going to be a rough one to pull back.
Now, I'm kind of surprised about this, but Terra looks like he's trying to rebuild the command center, but if he does that, there's no... Oh, there we go. He's changed his mind. He's going to try and build the missile turret, because if he builds that command center there, it's going to die again. And he has no anti-air, so... Oh, and there's some scourge for the vessel now. Can he out-micro it? Doesn't look like he can. He's trying to pull back. And there goes the vessel.
Takes out the vessel. Looks like he's going to try and bully down the remaining numbers of Goliaths yet again. Again, I'm just kind of curious about why there's no... Zergling. I think Zergling would be able to be a really good transition right now for Tai 2. There's not that much for anti Or, I mean, there's a lot of anti-air, there's not that much to fight the ground. I think Zergling can easily overwhelm things like Goliath in that number. But, at this point, I mean, there's a Hydralisk Den, there's a whole bunch of Hydras coming out now. So, Tai 2 just playing absolutely insane. In-game sounds are a little loud. Alright, let me slow down again.
Yeah, weirdly, I think that, Terra's trying to do his best with the one Volter he has, trying to do any damage he can. But as defense with Hydralisk, he hasn't laid any of his mines yet from that base, or from that Volter even. And when these Hydralisks decide to go an aim move, he's going to lose his natural. Like, you need a lot of Goliaths to be able to take on Hydralisks, and he just isn't going to have enough.
Yeah, I believe Goliaths struggle really hardly with. Because, I think, wait, do Goliaths do... What's the damage that they do on their ground attack?
It's 12, plus 1 because he has...
Right,
because
he also has a plus 1.
Yeah. Okay.
But yeah, here comes these, like, upgraded Hydralisks, so this is gonna be... probably the GG as soon as the Hydras show up with the Mutas.
Yeah, he's even got Overlord speed. He's making sure not to die to mines, but this still could be sketchy. I mean, we have seen in previous games that mines can still go off when you're least expecting it, but I mean, Hydralisks are pretty good, so... This guy, oh my god, he's even evacuating his natural. He's sending everything back to the main. That's it. He doesn't want to give up against Tai 2.
I mean... That's spirit, gotta say that. I mean, this is a single elimination torment. Oh my god, the science vessel! It does have at least one radiate and about to get another one. It looks like here comes the SCVs trying to go for the Maynard, trying to take out the Hydras before they're actually able to do anything. There is one irradiate, gonna do a good amount of damage to time, so it does go down.
He may be able to hold on with SCVs, I don't think so, but he's trying. Siege mode with two kills. Looks like the vessel went down, I believe.
Yeah, oh, no, it did.
He managed to get it back.
Oh no, that's just another one. Line.
Oh, it's a different one, okay.
Oh my god.
Tai 2 is running back home, but he's going for queens, so...
I think Tai 2 is just playing with his food at this point.
Yeah, he's like, I'll push in a little bit. I really don't need to kill you if I don't want to. He's going to send out some drones to expand in the bottom left. Funnily, there is mines there, so he's not going to be able to do it without protection, but... He could even just build hatcheries, like, by the gas. It doesn't even matter about the minerals at this point.
I mean... On one side, you have the stalwart person who's like, I'm not gonna give up until I'm literally out of the game, but... Tai 2, on the other hand, is like, alright, well, if you're gonna do this, then I'm just gonna have my fun and start doing a whole bunch of really fun things. No Hive yet, though, so we're not going into, like, something weird like Mass Ultralisks or something, just... Gonna build a billion hatcheries and take the whole entire map. People are asking about Tai 1 in chat. Don't ask about Tai 1.
Yeah, what happened with Tai 1?
No, we can't talk about Tai 1. We don't talk about Tai 1. Also like how we don't go to Ravenholm.
I guess technically you could call Tai 1 baby. And he plays StarCraft 2, but I don't think it's got anything to do with that.
Well, there's Tai 1, there's TYTY, now there's Tai 3. There's just a... Random noises.
That was my phone.
Actually, I wonder where my phone is. I haven't had track of that for a while. Oh, a bunch of Scourge gonna come in here, gonna take out the science vessel. And, I guess we're just gonna get into this situation. Now, actually, we're seeing the transfer back over into mech, into bio. We have a couple of barracks now going down.
Yeah, this is like, this is the latest bio switch I've ever seen. Like, the idea was like, I mean, you can go Valconic, which is like, you go for one factory, one starport. I also like how he's playing StarCraft 2 as well. He's got the barracks on the machine shop to build.
I was just about to note that. If only that was like a reactor in StarCraft 2, he might have a chance.
Oh, Terran would be so broken if they had that in Brood War.
Right? I mean, Terran is kind of broken in StarCraft 2 because they have that, but... Looks like the missile turret is going to go down, and just a whole bunch of Mutalisks coming in here. Spawn Broodling's going to take out the remaining siege tanks over here, and actually going to take out both of them. with spawn broodlings, and it looks like there is still one more down here in the corner at the natural. At this point, Taitu is at 153 supply, and Terror is at 43, so things are not looking too good. I mean, things haven't looked good for a while.
Yeah, I mean, I'd like to say that people say my GGs are ridiculous. The one from Terra here is just insane. Like, he's going into bio because he knows mech isn't going to work against the queens, but he's so far behind that bio just isn't going to do anything. The Hydras have plus one attack. He has no upgrades on his bio whatsoever. He can't. I don't even think he can afford them, if we're being honest. He's adding on another supply depot despite being 30 supply away from the cap. And he's just sort of just hanging in there. Maybe the replay's bugged or something, even though it's a live game. I don't know.
The replay's bugged. Dude, I would love it. Oh my god. Is that just parasites? Tons of parasites?
Yeah, parasited the SCVs. I don't know why.
Is there restoration? I think that's the test.
Oh, he's sending in the medic. Oh, it's actually just healing.
Yeah.
I do like how he gets to see the mineral line now, though. If he went for Guardians now, that'd be really cool. That'd be a really pimping play.
Coming here yet again with the Mutalisk, gonna try and take out the Sides Hustle, not gonna be successful in doing so.
Hypes up and Great Aspire as well, so there are gonna be some Guardians at some point when he decides to use them.
Or Devourers.
But rather than that, he's just gonna build every other base on the map. Like, Taitu.
Yeah, by the way, that has happened while we've been looking over here at the natural. Taitu has literally taken every other base on the map.
I don't know, this reminds me a lot of my games when I first started, where I'd be trying to win and like hold on, and then I'd look and then like the Protoss player or something had got every other base on the map, and I was like, oh, this feels bad.
That's exactly what happens, I think, in every single one of my TVPs. As soon as I stop moving any units, all of a sudden the Protoss has just instantly taken all other bases. They don't even have probes there, they just have it's just like a Nexus just starts warping in for them. Cocoon's now finally coming in. I am still just going to be, I'm going to be really brazen here and just assume that it's going to be, oh my god, there's so many Scourge.
Yeah, the Scourge.
Oh my god, there's so many Scourge.
I don't even know why he's bothered, he's just suiciding.
And completely missed all of the science vessels at that.
Yeah, and there's still more Scourge as well, at least I thought I saw some. Oh, maybe not.
Okay, so it is Guardians. By the way, Guardians have plus 2 base armor, with plus 2 carapace on top of that, 4 armor. These Marines have no upgrades, so they're gonna do 2 damage per shot to these Guardians.
And they also die super quickly as well. Marines, not too good against Guardians. It takes two shots to kill them without any upgrades, and it's just painful. Interestingly though, Taitu did warp those in the middle of the map. If it had just warped those above the natural, he could have won the game. I think he's still playing with his food.
I think he's still playing with his food as well. Takes out the remaining siege tanks. Oh, nope, we have one more siege tank down here. Okay, there we go. Alright, so, you know, Terra still has a shot.
2-1 done on the ground for range units, 1-1 for his melee units as well. And I really want to know if I think Terra has seen these other bases, although I'm not entirely sure. I mean, he can't really push out on the middle of the map. This is kind of sad.
I'm just going to watch Terra's point of view. Like, this is just what I'm going to do now, because I'm really curious to see what Terra thinks is going to happen. There's a dropship now. So, you know, there's that. Going for Terra.
I mean, Terra's going to try and get this mineral only. He really doesn't. Like, could you imagine if Taitu managed to pull the throw of the sentry and lost this game? Like, it would take a miracle for Terra to win this, and I'm usually quite optimistic for people, but this is just ridiculous.
I don't know. I think you really misunderstand the idea of Tesagi. And
I must admit, I mean, Terra's got plus one attack on his bio, and if I know anything from the Team Liquid forums, plus one attack is broken, man. So I think he's probably going to win now.
There's a bunch of lurkers now out here. And yeah, I think this is probably going to be Terra's game now. The Marines are out on the map. There is nothing harassing at home.
I don't know what base number this is. Probably like 12. I'm not sure.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is the 6th base, I think. The Guardians responded to that, by the way.
Oh my god, Taitu's even taken the 12 above base with Sunkins as well. This is just like a major troll at this point.
Okay, I think Terra still has it, but not all of the Marines are still dead. And it looks like they're gonna go down, and there's the GG finally. We do have a GG. And that's gonna be Tai 2 taking game number one. I can't believe Tai 2 was able to turn that game around. That is, I think, one of the most impressive things that I've seen. Apparently, you have become back to being just the Zoom support thing. I don't know what happened there.
Yeah, it's because I've been turning the camera off in between games, just so it doesn't lag anything.
Well then. Forget-
You turn back to the cameras really quickly, so I don't set it back on. But yeah, the thing is, Tai 2 didn't actually lose all that many drones. When you're going for like a two-hatch all-in or something, you only actually have like three drones or something at your natural. So maybe that wasn't his initial plan, but it worked out in the end. And you know what? I really wish we could have had like a doom zoom on Terra's face when he saw the amount of bases there are on the map.
It was like... Starts comm scatting.
He's like slowly comm sats around the map and he's like getting closer to his own bases and he looks at his own mineral only and there's a hatch there and it's like, god damn it, no!
So it looks like we're getting closer and closer to the semifinals.
Looks like Doc Holliday's screaming about that.
Yeah. We're making sure that we don't miss any of the semifinal games. I think we're just going to do each of the semifinals at a time. So it looks like we're going to go back to Circuit Breaker, which you can do.
The salty run back, or whatever you call it.
Yes.
I remember that from the last time you did this. That was kind of funny.
So it's a smash rule, and the idea is basically, game's up. Yep. Basically, the idea is you're saying, I can beat you on this map. I know I can, and you know you lose game number one. You can take it back to game number two, challenge them again on the same match because, you know, there's a lot of different strategies you can play on a map or on a stage in Melee and in Brood War, and so I think it's a really fun like, wow, this is. Really weird. They're the same colors again. Okay, that makes my life way easier.
It would have been cooler if they were the same positions too.
Right?
That would have been great.
I didn't want to do the time warp again though, so I'm kind of glad that we don't have that. Alright, so spawning down here in the bottom right hand corner, we've got from Team SCC our yellow Zerg player currently up 1-0 to their opponent. It is Tai 2.
And spawning once again as the Orange Terran, it is his opponent, gonna need two games to win the series. It's gonna be Terra.
So, two games, Circuit Breaker, game number two. What would be your game number three here if you are currently up against, if it's 1-1, you've got a Zerg opponent, what would you pick for your next map here?
I mean, it'd be very unlikely that I would get into a position of having a third game against the Zerg. I would just lose 0-2, but if I did, I think I might play Third World, because it's a cool map.
Third World! Yeah, we already did have one game on Third World, Cadency versus Mind.
Yeah, that was a really, really interesting game. Like, I don't know who Mind is. I know he's a Korean, but he's not proper Mind. But his APM was just so high. Like, he was doing so much stuff at once. Like, that was insane.
Wait, are we sure that that wasn't proper Mind?
I'm almost certain because Mind wasn't going to play in the STPL, which was like a couple of hours before, because Gyro said that it was a bit too late for Mind to play, so...
But maybe this was just early enough.
I'm not sure, because that would have been later.
Maybe it rolls back around. I don't know. Alright, anyway. So, we do have a proxy Rax to a 9 pool.
Yeah. Oh, no. This is like a build order loss for Terra, I think.
Yeah.
As long as Tai 2 gets a decent amount of blings, he's gonna be able to hold this off. And he's actually drone scouting this time. He doesn't want to do the same thing he did before.
Well, it's a 9 into 11, so this is really weird here. Because it's an 11 hatch, which means that there's a lot of minerals spent on not Zergling. So, it's not going to be like in a really aggressive 9 pool opening, it's just going to be almost like a kind of ZVP style, where typically Zergs will be going like 11 hatch 10 pool to deal with
now,
one gate, but...
I think he should know something's up, because he did see one of the SCVs scouting the other way, and he's just seen another one immediately get to his base, so he should know that there's going to be a bunker coming up here. Whether or not Terra builds the bunker far back or right next to the hatchery, I guess we're about to find out, but
nope,
it'd be pretty dangerous. Oh no, he's just pulling back.
Yeah, Terra's just going to retreat. And a good call here, because with that 9 pool, it's going to be just a lot of Zergling that are just going to be able to just completely surround. And actually, wow, Tai 2 saw that and is still building out drones.
Yeah, he's seen the Marines have gone back, although here we go, he's got a few more Marines now, he's going to move forward. Looks like we're going to have a third hatchery as well, so Tai 2 playing a little bit greedy given the situation, but I think he should feel pretty safe right now. He's got about 8 links, no, 6 links even, or 4 links, I can't count, we're getting there. But it should be enough to hold off, I think, as long as he stops the bunker going up.
Yeah, there's a couple more lings that were in the main as well, so it's a good number of lings, but these SCVs are getting into a really good position to wall. And with that, actually, that third hatchery makes a huge place for those Marines to go sit into a, like, favorable position. This is going to be really difficult, I think. Potentially, no, okay, really good drone drill. Oh my god, that drone drill.
Yeah, that drone drill may have just won Tai 2 the game, although he's still taking a little bit of damage. The Marines aren't going to be able to get to the bunker, though, and that's the biggest story so far.
Oh my god, what an amazing hold there by Tai 2. Really nice micro there at the end though by Terra, and it looks like Terra is just going to back up, go for the expansion. Still pumping out Marines out here, but I don't know what's going to happen considering there's a lot of Zergling that are now going to start getting pumped out. No, never mind. Tai 2's gone back to drones again.
I was going to say, if Tai 2 goes for Lings, I think he could actually just win the game right now. But because he's got into drones, maybe he's planning to play with his opponent a little bit. Terra has forced out the Sunken, so that's 100 minerals less for what he wanted. There is a Ling in his main, though. That's kind of annoying. It's not going to be able to kill anything, but it's still like the perfect scouting tool.
Well, I mean, SCVs are overpowered, and Lings can't actually fight them. Oh my god, this one Marine barely gets into the bunker! And wow, those Zergling were really hurt. They're just going to get slaughtered, actually, by that one Marine in the bunker. Oh, Tai 2's drones are stuck.
Oh no. Oh, that's not good. The anti-wall. What? I'm really confused as to why he killed both of them though. He could have possibly pushed them through. Maybe. I'm not too sure, but he's gonna actually have to lava trick to get the lava on the right side. Looks like he is doing that.
Oh my god.
That's going to allow him to... Oh, sorry, on the left side. That's going to allow him to build his drones, but that's kind of annoying.
This is the comical series here.
We got a Hydralis Den coming up, and a Lair at the same time, so we could see a Lurker opening here from Tai 2. In the past, he has been known to do this. This was, like, his main style for quite a while. He does have those three hatcheries, though, but two of them, or one of them, he's going to find it very hard to build Hydras from.
You can build Hydras, you just have to constantly larva trick all the time.
Yeah, it looks like he's doing that at the moment. He's doing a pretty good job of it. I guess it's good practice.
Like, I mean,
he has to keep an eye on his lava more, because he's always got to do the lava trick on it.
Wouldn't it be funny if Terra just popped out one Wraith, took out that Overlord over there, and now Tai 2 is in a terrible position, because I have to put an Overlord into another awkward position to get the larva trick again?
That would be pretty funny. I think he should be okay, though. These lava, they're working out, though.
I know, watching them just, like, kind of have to crawl around the hatchery constantly.
The funny thing is, because it walls off on the bottom left, they have to wall the whole... Or they walk the whole way around the hatchery. I've never seen that before.
Okay, so, we do have a pretty standard transition out of this by Terror. And, in fact, I think Tai 2... had a much easier time playing with his food last game, but this game is actually a little bit scary, and I don't know if Tai 2 should be playing so brazenly here. There's a bunch of Hydras hiding in a corner over here, and I am so curious as to what they are doing. Meanwhile, we do have the lair, we do have the Hydra Den, so we're going to be most likely seeing Lurkers right behind this. Likely a slow Lurker drop, considering that this Overlord over here is not scouting Terror at all.
It would be very difficult to do a slow Overlord drop there. It'd take a little bit too long, but he's morphing those Lurkers in the like left middle of the map. It's going to make it a little bit more difficult for Terra to push over. The important thing is he did scout what was going on, so Terra should know he's going to be safe.
Yeah, I'm kind of curious about what Terra's going to do here. I mean, when you see lurkers, you generally move directly across the map and try and cancel Tai 2's ability to just kind of get those lurkers already at your natural. But Terra's kind of playing this really weird right now. I guess seeing those Zergling trying to play defensive, but oh my god, the lurkers are just going to walk around the other side.
Yeah, this is going to be painful for Terra. He's building the second bunker. He knows he needs this. He's not got any detection, though. He's got... Okay, so he's got two scans, but no turret at the bunkers, which is kind of a risky play. But here we go. The lurkers are all pushing in from all different angles. Is this going to be enough to break through?
Ooh, Taito didn't actually burrow those lurkers correctly. And had to pull them back. There's no missile turret back here, but three bunkers is generally what you need to deal with something like a three-hatch lurker push.
Yeah, oh my god, that's so many lurkers, though.
It is. And, so fun fact, ladies and gentlemen, actually, if you don't know this, if you don't have plus one weapons, your U-255 shells on your marines, they don't outrange lurkers in bunker. They don't have equal range to lurkers in a bunker. So, if you don't have that upgrade, lurkers can just outrange a bunker before you actually can do anything. But as soon as you do get that upgrade, you can equal range lurkers. Oh my god, the lurker's going in, doing so much damage! The bunker falls so fast!
I thought that was going to go much better for Terra there. He did have the firebat in the bunker as well, and it was shredding down the lanes, but there's just too many lurkers. Terra with a very, very quick loss here again.
Oh man, trying to hold down this last bunker, but the SCVs are just getting absolutely shredded. The Comsat scan is about to run out. Another Comsat does go down. But I believe at this point, Terra has run out of Comsat scans. Yeah, there are none left.
The only thing he can really do at this point is kill his Comsat and rebuild it. That's actually quicker than waiting for the scan.
Is it really?
Yeah, that's a really, really cool trick you can do.
I've never known that. I'm going to start doing that more often. And then fail. And like just end up with no Comsat.
Yeah, that's why it's kind of awkward to do. It certainly happened to me. This is so annoying when this happens, when there's like a single lurker in range of the Comsat and you can't save it.
And the SCV's gonna try and come over and save it, but not gonna happen. There's one scan left. Waiting for that SCV, waiting for the sea tank to get into range. It will take out one of those lurkers, and now they're just gonna back up. Tai 2, meanwhile, has taken a third base. Starting to get Hive, getting a Spire at the same time. Messed up the egg building at the third hatchery again.
Now, weirdly enough, I don't know how, but Terra did manage to hold on to that. He's got his science facility up now. He's going to be able to go into vessels. Doesn't need to rely on scan as much, but it's going to be so hard to push across these bridges. It's like his plus one armor is a very, very long way away. He's probably getting plus one weapons at the moment. And in case, to any viewers that don't know, if you do not have plus one armor, marines die to two lurker spines, so they die so quickly.
Yeah, they do. I mean, that's like one of the biggest upgrades you need to get as soon as you realize that your opponent's going into lurkers. In fact, normally, because I'm really bad, I just generally skip getting plus one weapons if I notice that my opponent's going for lurkers, so I can get plus one armor that much quicker. There is a dropship, though, and this is really, really good play here from Terry. It's actually like one of the best counters to lurker play, because without the Spire being up and a lot of Mutas and Scourge being around, typically the dropship will be able to get across the map pretty easily.
Yeah, interestingly, Tai 2's taken a kind of greedy base. Like, this base isn't, well, it's not really greedy, I guess, but it's kind of an interesting base to take. It doesn't give you easy access to a fourth base, which is why you'd often see Zergs going for that other main to get the natural as soon as they get the filers, but Tai 2 may find himself a little bit stuck.
Alright, so there's Scourge out now. The Niners are now trying to go up. Here's the drop. Firebat here, though, so this is going to be able to hold off a lot of these links pretty easily. Really nice micro with the medic as well.
Nice, he's going to go for the gas. That's one really nice building to take for. Oh, he's moving his tanks across the bridge. They're running straight into lurker fire. He's going to lose two tanks. He's not paying attention.
Oh no, at the same time, losing the push over here. And the Scourge take out the dropship. The tanks barely survive. Science Vessel now finally out. Ooh.
Yeah, that That tank was one hit away from dying. He got incredibly lucky that the passing screwed him up in the right direction.
And now at this point, Defiler Tech has come out, and there is at least one Science Whistle out, and probably Irradiate, but that still leaves enough time for the Defiler to be able to throw down the Dark Swarm before anything, and that can just ruin your day.
Yeah, the one important thing for Terror is he has actually been mixing in a couple of Firebats, which will help a lot with the Swarm. I mean, he's going to need to be very careful with his Vessel. He needs that Radiate on the first Defiler. If he can't hit that Radiate, he could find himself in a very bad position. He's also got Scourge. Two drones stuck again.
Scourge! Going for the Science Whistle, not going to be able to find it, but that's a lot of Scourge now floating around here. And instead opting to go for... Oh no, this one tank. One tank, what are you doing, one tank?
Yeah, that poor tank did not want to live anymore.
There's a Defiler over here as well. Okay, so there are two Defilers out here right now for Tai 2.
Oh, he's pulled his other tank in, and I thought they were both going to die to the Ling, so he does just about keep them alive. Fourth base going up in the 6 o'clock position, and there's a big counterattack going around the 12 o'clock here. Defiler with Lings. There is 3 Firebats, though. That should be enough to hold this off, but it's going to be quite dicey.
Yeah, these are fire. These Lings have had Hive Tech for a while now, so they also have their crackling upgrades, adrenal glands. So they are going to do a lot of damage, and if these Firebats aren't in the best position, they are going to get shredded apart. But the medics actually are doing a really, really good job of keeping this one Firebat back here alive. That one Siege Tank just barely surviving there, and now finally sieging up over here on the third base.
One thing I've noticed, Terra doesn't seem to like repairing his units. One of the major benefits that Terran has over Zerg is you can repair, and he's just letting his tanks sit on really low health for a very long time.
Dropping the main base as well, gonna start going for some of that tech structures. Meanwhile, third base does have a Dark Swarm on top of the Lurkers to keep everything alive. Double Defilers getting irradiated back here in the back. Lurkers trying to come up here to defend.
Yeah, he is. He's got that one Lurker under Swarm though, and as any Terran player will know, if there's one Lurker under Swarm, you may as well just turn around, because you're never breaking in that base. Weird choice of attack on the Queen's Nest, though. I think he could have got the Defiler Mound if it focused it.
Yeah, I mean, still has a couple units left alive here, and they could potentially still do more damage. Coming in here, poking in at the Irradiate on the Defiler back there yet again. Leaving the third base! Okay, so the Dark Swarm was just too much.
Yeah, he lost both his tanks, and you're not really going to be able to break down a small ramp against 3 Lurkers.
No, the 2 tanks are there, they're just really hurt.
Yeah, he doesn't have +1 armor still as well. So that's going to be a very, very dangerous position to push into. But once again, there's another 2 tanks, both of them on red health before they even get in any like major engagements. Looks like we do have some SCVs. Pulling with a few units to go down to this 4th base, a single Vulture with 3 kills so far. Well, about to be 3 kills. Gonna take all the drones there. And he's finally pushed into the 3rd base.
Defiler desperately trying to throw down the Dark Swarm. It will be successful. Needs to pull these Marines back just a little bit so that they're outside of the Dark Swarm and be able to handle this. Siege Tank's helping though from afar. There's the Irradiate now going down on top of those Defilers to take them out yet again. Looks like the Siege Tanks will get jumped up on top of by the Zergling, but the fourth base falls as that all happens.
Yep, this is one of the problems Tai 2 has by taking this 9 o'clock base as his third. He doesn't have that easily defendable second choke to defend his 2 bases, so it's a lot harder for him to hold on to these additional bases here. And we're going to see another drop going into the main. It's going to try and land on top of these extra medics as well. So.
There's an SCV there. SCV, what are you doing here?
The SCV is the main man of this drop. He's actually going to man a CC. I'm calling it now.
Oh my god, I hope so. Oh my god, I hope so.
I think you bought it by accident, but I'd love to see a man a CC.
Ooh, and a whole bunch of Zerglings running straight on into Firebats. Let's talk about the world's most one-sided fight. Firebats prevail.
Yeah, Firebats are pretty cool units. I mean, that one's on 9 health, though. And the medic doesn't want to heal it. Oh, here we go.
Okay. Gonna get back up. It's at 2-1 right now. Ooh, the medics, again, just distracted. Did not want to heal them. I think Tai 2 just lost.
Just about to die. There's a huge force coming into his natural. He doesn't have any Defilers here.
All the Defilers are at the third! Oh my god, it barely gets over here. If only Ultra was able to actually, or sorry, Terra was able to actually take out the Nidus Canal before anything.
He can't build any units but Hydralisks right now. Hydralisks and the Defilers, that's all he can make. He's trying to rebuild the spawning pool at his natural. It's just about finished. He's on three bases, barely mining on the third.
There's a massive counterattack at the third mineral, only here for Terra, but there's just no damage being done, and that's GG. 1-1.
Yeah, Terra did a really good job of surgically pulling apart Tai2 at the end of the game there. He just had units in all the places that Tai2 didn't. And I think a lot of it comes down to the Nidus positioning as well. Usually you see sort of Prozergs building the Nidus in the main. And Tai2 had it at the top of his natural, so when the drop did come into his main base, it took a long time for the units to get back there.
Oh my god, what a crazy turn of events there. So let's get on into game number 3 between these two. Once Tai2 actually joins the chat. Oh my god. Well, I'm going to take a quick look at the brackets as well while we do that. Hit the magic button on the magic button thing. We got Eon Zerg versus HDY, who I believe is Miso. We got DeWalt versus Mind. That's currently 1-1. Wow. Dandy is going to fight the winner of this series. And True Touch versus Babbo right now is in 42 minutes long.
Now, a Dandy game could be kind of interesting. Like, Tai2, his CBT is pretty good, like we've seen in the previous two games. Looks like we're going to head on to Gladiator as the third map, but we could have Terra versus Dandy, and those two have quite a long and varied history with each other. I've seen a lot of their games, even in just the Clash for Char, and it's been pretty crazy.
By the way, you mentioned Clash for Char. Do me a favor, please tell everybody about your tournament. It's still running, am I correct?
Okay, so Clash of Char is kind of on hiatus right now, just because I'm focusing mostly on STPL. But also, it allows Havatyu some more room to breathe. There's so many tournaments at the moment that any more weeklies are just kind of too many. So I'm mainly focusing on my team league I'm running now. That's the first cast of that is going to be tomorrow. Going to go on Monday, Wednesday, Friday. All the games were played today, I believe, so I don't have all the replays yet, but should have them soon. And that should be a lot of fun. It allows Havatyu to have Sunday, BSL on Saturday, Brute War Clan League as well on Sunday. There's just so many tournaments going on right now, it's really hard to keep track of everything. There's even the Team Liquid organized One Bang as well. I casted one of those yesterday, it was a lot of fun.
Oh, yeah.
And I think the next one's in 2 weeks, that was on Saturday, so that'll be in 2 weeks Saturday again. That was cool.
Yeah, apparently I've been pushed out of Saturdays. I should have never stopped doing Have At You so I could always have my Saturdays back. We do have the game hosted up, by the way, so if you could join that, and we'll get into game number 3. But once you do join, I do also want you to talk about your other tournament, the BSTL.
BSTL? Or, that's not me.
Sorry, Siege... STPL, right? There's so many acronyms!
Okay, so the tournament I'm running now is the Shinhan Tank Pro League. I ran it the first time in 2015, and before the idea was you would play as like a pro gamer ID, and you'd pretend to be like one of the teams from Pro League 2010. But now it's just play as your own IDs. We've got 14 teams. It's going to be a lot of fun. Cool map pool. So far the prize pool is $500, thanks to Gabriel Villain. Like the man who paid like bankrolls all of the tournaments in Brood War, I think. And yeah, it's going to be a lot of fun. But we're now in this game, so to start us off, I guess, in the bottom right, we do have the Purple Zerg. It's SCC's Tai2.
Spawning up here in the top left-hand corner, it is our green Terran player. It is Terror. I forgot green is actually still a thing you can spawn as in use map settings, so I didn't tell... I didn't tell my friend who did all like the color coding and everything for all this that green is potential, because I was just thinking about the normal ladder colors. Oh man. Oh,
wait, can you all spawn as green in ladder?
I don't think so. Green is player 9, I think is why. I think in ladder you can only spawn as the first 8 players.
Okay, that makes sense. They should replace green with brown, because no one likes spawning as brown, I don't think. It's so hard to see on some of the maps, especially the mini-map as well.
Yeah, I'm really hoping that they come out with a way to just make it just red versus blue, always. That would be awesome. But at the same time, on a map like this, blue kind of blends in a little bit.
It does. This tile set is not good for dark blue. That's why I think, like, one of my things that I really want Blizzard to do, and I know there's so many other problems that people mention and things, but the only thing I care about is I want to be able to pick orange and just play as orange all the time.
Yeah, but then on orange desert maps, you always have orange.
Yeah, but that's fine. That's okay. You can do Shift-Tab, make me red. It's all good.
So, yeah, I mean, like, this is, like, one of the fun things that, you know, I've been thinking about. Is like, if you had to pick two colors that would always stand out on the minimap for all tile sets, what would they be? And I was thinking just red and green. No, green kind of blends in on Fighting Spirits.
Yeah, I think the only one that really stands out is red. Like, there's so many different tile sets, so many different colors. I guess the only one is white, because we don't play any snow maps.
Oh, but what if we did? Oh, thank God we don't, by the way. What is this drone doing? I think, actually, Tai-2 doesn't know how to scout on Gladiator.
Maybe he's checking for an 8-Rax, but then again, he didn't go up the ramp, so it wouldn't be a very successful scout. Possibly just a misclick, I guess. By the way, I'd just like to point out, I don't live in a jail. Like, every time I show my camera, everyone looks at my door and they're like, oh my god, you live in a jail. It's like, no, it's just a 120-year-old door. And, like, the wood is there to, like, stop, A, the noise, and stop, like, the wind coming through the door, because it's pretty bad.
I mean, I mean, in San Francisco, all the old buildings are completely heavy wooden doors and everything, too. I live in a newer building now, so it's just like a standard dorm room-looking door now, but... looks like we're gonna have, actually, a pretty aggressive opening yet again from Terror. Going for the bunker. It's about to finish. It's so incredibly close. The Marines are taking so much damage. Oh, both of them get in!
Oh, this is not good. Tai-2 after a dominating first game. Finding himself in an awful position now. It's in range of the hatchery. Oh, poor Tai-2. He's lost so many drones already as well.
And with two SCVs to be able to repair that, that's going to be a lot of damage. The remaining drones are coming back here. The Zergling have come out. But nothing's repairing. It's not repairing it yet. Oh my god, that's a lot of damage. The bunker is taking so much damage. This actually...
Tai-2 holds just about. He didn't actually lose that many drones to the bunker. So that's pretty useful for him. Got a bit lucky with the targeting there.
But right now, I think this is looking really bad here for Terror. I mean, that's a lot of Marines that he lost. Okay, he's building up enough. It looks like he's going to complete the wall down here. But still... Good hold there by Tai-2. I almost consider this just game over.
Yeah, I don't think he can actually be killing type wall on this map, from what I can remember. He's not going to bother trying to wall. He's actually just going for a bunker. He knows that he could actually lose to a Ling counterattack. But Tai-2 not actually sending all of his Lings out at once, so...
Yeah, I think actually having this SCV scout out that all these Lings are back here, I think Terror is going to probably be just completely... sighing with relief because all the Lings are not going over to his natural, instead trying to be aggressive on the other side of the map, or trying to stop the scout from the other side of the map, and Terror also getting the full scout out of what's going on Tai-2's base. Terror's gotta be feeling really good right now.
Yeah, Tai-2's drone count's low, he's forced out of Sunken as well, Lings aren't able to do anything, there's a bunker with four Marines, Terror should be able to expand pretty soon. But looks like we are going to see the Academy first with another Supply Depot. So 2-Rax Academy from Terror. We may even see a little bit of an all-in from here as he can take that momentum he gained from his previous attack. Yep, we're going to see... Oh no, that's a factory. He's going for quick vessels.
Or maybe just back into quick mech like game number one, but game number one didn't go so well. So most likely quick vessels. But we'll have to keep in mind.
He could be going for the handbang timing, which is, I think it hits around 9:30.
Minutes.
Yeah, 9:30.
Probably going to be a little bit delayed now, just because of the whole entire early game was very delaying on both sides, but probably around 10 minutes is going to hit, but it's okay, because Tai-2 is super far behind in terms of just like everything that happened there in the beginning.
Yeah, and it's also going to get much worse for him. He's about to push in with a lot of Lings, but there's going to be a firebat in the bunker, and he is not going to be able to break the bunker with a firebat in it.
Okay, so.
Oh, and Terra's actually seen some lings going off onto the map. He's not seen all of them, so he's not fully prepared for this at the moment. But if, oh, he needs to pull his marines back. If he doesn't pull his marines back, he may actually lose this game.
Scouting us, Zergling are going to be able to see a lot of them. Oh, moving out of the middle of the map. I don't know about this. If these Zergling get into a really good position, they can easily collapse on top of all these, this Bioforce and just turn this game on its head again. Bio moving down here into the bottom right. Looks like it's going to go for an aggression on Tai 2. Tai 2 at the same time, I think, is going to go for the counter-aggression with a couple of Sunkins. I think Tai 2 can hold this, but there's nothing started.
Oh no, there's all of Terra's units are out in the middle of the map. The Lings are streaming in, the bunker's going to go down. And Terra's going to find himself in a lot of trouble now.
Yeah, but in a base race situation, I think this goes in favor of Terra. Tai 2 does not have that much defending back here.
He does have one Sunken though, and Sunken's pretty good units.
Yeah, but...
colonies in his main, so if he can hold on at his natural long enough.
Okay, maybe if these two Sunkens are able to finish up, that might be able to hold this off, but Terra can just lift off, so that's where things get a little bit difficult. There's a whole bunch of fire bats coming out here as well.
Pretty much all the SUVs are dead, minus there's two fire bats trying to hold on. The starport's like even going down itself. He's going to lose his main command center. It's burning down.
Yeah, but on the side of the map, Terra has taken out everything on Tai 2's base. The Sunken colonies are not going to be successful in going down.
Oh, poor Tai 2. I think he's actually just lost the game. He's going to get eliminated. Unless he can build a gas somewhere, I think he's actually just dead. The Firebat's in the main, killing so many Lings.
Oh, but they are going to finally go down. The Zergling are trying to do as much damage as possible, but there's just nothing left here for Tai 2 in the main base.
Tai 2 can't afford to build any more buildings. As soon as that final hatchery goes down, Tai 2 will be eliminated. He has no way of taking out the flying buildings.
Just lift one building! Just lift one building! Don't let them all burn!
He's already lifted
his... Oh, okay, the command center is okay. It's not burning anymore.
Yeah, he's fine.
Oh my god, Tai 2.
Tai 2 is bound to go bad.
With the fantasy GG timing.
I don't know, Fancy would only ever stay in if he had one SCV, or at least a CC and enough minerals to build one SCV. Tai 2 has nothing. This is such an unfortunate way for Tai 2 to end the tournament. After such a dominating game in game 1, his Ling All In wasn't like... I guess it kind of worked. Terra's kind of screwed, but he's got nothing that shoots up, and that's the big problem.
Tai 2 is chatting in the Discord chat right now. well played, excellent play, GG's. That is going to be Tai 2 getting knocked out there by Terror in a 2-1. Oh, what a great play there by Terror.
Yeah, that was such a split second decision to make as well. I'm not sure I would have made that decision. I would have tried to hold on to my base. But the fact is, the very fact he actually pushed in and didn't try and turn around actually won him the game. I think he built nothing but fire bats once the Lings got into his main, so that's kind of funny.
Okay, that kind of does look like you live in a jail.
Okay.
I never actually looked at that.
It's not